Live from the San Jose Convention Center, extracting the signal from the noise, it's theCUBE, covering Hadoop Summit 2015. Brought to you by headline sponsor Hortonworks, and by EMC, Pivotal, IBM, Pentaho, Teradata, SyncSort, and by Attunity. WAN Disco, now your host, John Furrier.
Okay, welcome back everyone. We're here live in Silicon Valley at the Hadoop Summit 2015. This is theCUBE, our flagship program. We go out to the event. So let's check the signal from those. I'm John Furrier. Winding down day three, it's starting to break down. 3 days of wall-to-wall coverage. Go to siliconangle.tv, check out all the action. Our next guest is Murthy Mathiprakasam, Principal Product Marketing Manager for Informatica. Covers all the big data. Welcome to theCUBE.
Thank you very much.
So what products do you manage? Just explain to the folks out there, what is the big data products or product?
Absolutely. So, you know, Informatica's been around for 20 years, and so we've built a lot of technology around data integration, data quality, master data management, data governance, and so we've taken all of the technology, ported it over to Hadoop, which is obviously the platform that's the most exciting platform now, and we've packaged that all together as one product. So customers who are used to using all of our functionality, they can now run that functionality on top of Hadoop, and it's just very, very easy for them.
So easy to consume, packaging-wise, you bundle everything in.
Exactly.
Different levels of, you know, scale, based
standard. You can start small and grow.
Entry-level, classic product pricing.
You got
positioning.
It.
Okay, great. So we are at theCUBE at Informatica World. We didn't get a chance to have this chat with you. But we were very impressed. So the CEO came on, all the top executives. It was really fantastic. And I was very impressed with how relevant you guys are on the messaging and where the product direction is on the product side. What is that all about with you guys? I mean, you guys are seeing something that a lot of other people aren't seeing. You're seeing the real time. And it's hard for a big company to shift and move so quickly. What is it? Is it the founder? Is it the team? What gives you that edge right now?
I would say the team is very unique in being able to look at the trends that are going on in the market. We have we're not a large corporation, and so we are a company that is uniquely very much tied to our customers. We had customer advisory councils actually at Informatica World, and we're constantly engaging with them and understanding what are the new initiatives that they're working on. So as they make transitions to new platforms, whether it's a Oracle Exadata or an SAP HANA or Hadoop or any of these new platforms, we hear that from our customers because we're engaging with them so frequently. And we've also built our technology in a way that we can make these transitions to new platforms very quickly, because that's why customers come to us. They don't want to have to deal with the migration pains. They want to use us and have us kind of abstract a lot of those pains for them. So in a way, it's sort of the foundation of the company to do exactly that. And so that's one of the reasons.
What's the big wins at your back? There's a lot of wins shifting. You talk about analytics, markets, obviously moving fast along. But I feel like the tide is being sucked out for the big tsunami that is the cloud. Customers are being impacted at the data center operationally. The processes and value chains are being disrupted. Yet the performance and economics are going to drive to the cloud. So this cloud trend is sistering up against the analytics.
Absolutely.
So it seems like analysts just like waiting for the big event that's coming. I feel the pressure.
That's right.
In a good way.
That's
Do you
right.
guys agree? What are some of those other elements that are driving the opportunities right now?
Well, I think you're exactly right. You know, as applications are moving from on-premise to off-premise, into the cloud, I always get mixed up here. You know, you're absolutely right. The applications are moving, and that means the data is moving as well. And it's one thing to just, you know, move the application over, but you got to get all your data, your customer data, your product data, your supplier data. And that's where a lot of IT teams struggle. And this is exactly what our technology is designed around. You know, in the old days, we were just moving data around within IT, but there's no reason you can't apply the exact same technology for moving the data from outside of an enterprise into a cloud environment.
So I got to ask you about the data, because this has really become a kind of a Cold War battleground state, if you will, in the winning of the big data landscape, and that is that who owns the data? So the app workloads drive tooling and platforming, but where do you put the data? So at Informatica, we talked about master data.
That's right.
So let's put my old school hat on. Pretend I'm a software company, and I'm like, 1990s kind of software company. I want to own the data. I'm going to lock them in. I'm going to make it a freebie, get them in. You know, Roche Motel, once you check in, you can't check out kind of model.
Right.
That's the old school enterprise software license.
That's right.
That's competitive strategy 101 in the 90s. What's different today about the data? What are customers looking for? Because lock-in is gone. It's about choice now.
That's right.
Because you really, with open source, lock-in is kind of difficult. You can have a competitive advantage and have stickiness. That's not lock-in. That's just value, right? So
that's right.
No lock-in, but choice has to be maintained. So how do you give someone choice, stickiness, no lock-in?
Well, so I think it really comes down to, first of all, you have to always look at who's the end consumer here, and it's your analysts. It's the data scientists. It's the business analysts. And we are moving to an environment that is inevitably more autonomous. We just can't have a bunch of rules and regulations that prevent these users to get data. And so it's all about designing a system that enables agility and autonomy, but also preserves security, compliance. I mean, laws aren't going anywhere. So if you're in the US, you're in Europe, I mean, there are privacy regulations, and these are all for good reasons. And so it's about designing a system that enables agility and autonomy, but that also preserves your ability to, you know, maintain internal controls, maintain compliance with external regulations. And it's that balance that I think these platforms can provide.
And what's next on the product side? We're getting kind of short on time here. What's going on with Informatica's products? What's happened after the event? It was only a few weeks ago in Las Vegas. Great event. It was really top shelf, a lot of energy. I was really impressed. So what's next now for you guys?
Well, what's next is, I think it's really just extending everything that we've done in the past. You know, we have this very unique notion of data intelligence where we can understand the data and the structure of the data very uniquely because we see everything that's going through the pipelines. And so if we can take those insights and surface them to end users and to administrators, so we have a product called Secure at Source, for example, that we just launched right before Informatica World. It's a great example of this. Basically, we can look at data sets and find where there's sensitive data. So if you've got social security numbers or credit card numbers, and this is something that's very important in the world of big data, because
fraud detection, real time, omnichannel marketing.
That's right.
You know, real time in the moment. I mean, first of all, I'm not really a big fan of this 360-degree view of the customer, of all persona. I am, but I don't like how people are globbing onto it like a buzzword, because with real time and first party data, 360-degree view changes at every step the user takes.
That's right.
And so, like, the context is so rapid that is changing. So.
You know, but that's part of the 360 view. I think you're right in that it's not a static view. It is a dynamic view of the customer.
Do you guys have that?
Absolutely. 100%. We've got a real-time streaming engine. We have customers who actually use that.
Maybe I won't diss it too much then, because what I see people doing is saying, oh, we have 360-degree view of the customer. No, but you're lagging. That's the day or maybe longer. Just persona day. Well, what's that person doing right now?
No, absolutely.
Well, they were in San Jose, flew to Vegas. Wait a minute, they're buying stuff. It's a fraud detection. No, they just flew from Southwest to Vegas, which is Mike's case.
Absolutely.
So
no, absolutely.
This is the issue, right, that you guys are solving?
Absolutely. Well, there are many issues that we solve, but this is
no, but in this one use case, it's real time.
Absolutely. You know, another great example of this that's a little less consumer focused directly is sensors. So you have a lot of industrial companies, energy companies. We've got one customer who they want to know how much energy all of their customers are using every minute, so they can do forecasting, they can do planning at a minute level. And this is fundamentally different from a couple of years ago, like you're saying, where you look at daily or weekly forecasts.
This is exciting. Again, you guys have your finger on the pulse. I think that is the action that I see. And that impacts every business. Advertising, recommendation engines, sensors, airplanes, machinery.
Absolutely.
Humans with mobile devices.
The world is getting faster, not slower.
I always say Internet of Things is people and machines, right? People are things too, right?
So, that's right.
Murthy, we got to get the hook here. So appreciate you coming by. I know we were crunched on time. They're tearing down. We'll go right to the last seconds here at theCUBE, where all the action is. Going to have to pull the chair from me. This is theCUBE. We'll be right back after the short break. Informatica on theCUBE. We'll be right back.